compassion for Kibera. Auriga Family Foundation. Several members of the Auriga family travel on dirt roads through the Great Rift Valley in Kenya. They are on their way to the capital, Nairobi, where they visit a family in Makina, in Kibera, Africa's second largest slum. The roads are dusty and full of baboons. Nairobi. Maasai men lead their cattle to water and grass. It is a turbulent time because of the upcoming national elections. Shoes are made from old car tires. Uncollected waste is one of Nairobi's most visible problems. This is due to the high population pressure and poor waste management. Skins are drying on a field in the city centre. The decorations and blaring music of the matatus celebrate whatever is hip and popular. Nairobi has a population of around 5 million, of which 60% live in slums. The slums take up less than 6% of the residential land in the capital. Korogosho, Matha, and Baba Nogo are located around the huge Dandora dump. Every day, 850 tons of waste is thrown in the dump site and hand-sorted by women and children for less than 3 euro cents per kilo. Several members of the Auriga family meet up with former street boys who show them around in downtown Nairobi. There are around 300,000 kids living on the streets, of which 10% is under the 5 years old. They live in gangs for protection and often have no other option than to steal and beg to ensure they have something to eat. They are exposed to starvation, violence, sexual exploitation, and drug abuse. Kibera, the biggest slum of Nairobi. The United Nations estimate there may be as many as 1.6 million people living in the 14 villages that Kibera is divided in. The smell of poverty is overwhelming. A mixture of rotting waste and open sewage gutters. Due to the high population density, there are many problems of drainage and sanitation. Most sewage runs downhill in open ditches. One toilet is shared by more than 200 people. These are constantly overloaded. As a result, many residents use a plastic bag as a toilet. This is then thrown onto the ever-growing rubbish dumps, which causes a major health risk. In some parts of Kibera, the train to Uganda passes dangerously close to the shacks, blowing dust and debris from slum life. Clean water is often difficult to access and can become contaminated by sewage. The locals cook on wood, petroleum or charcoal. It's sold in small buckets for a few shillings. Let's walk through the labyrinth of narrow alleys. Kibera is a place for those who cannot afford legal housing. With a majority coming from one of the many Kenyan tribes like the Kikuyu, it's also a destination for migrants fleeing rural poverty and constant wars. People from neighboring countries like Uganda, Somalia, and South Sudan followed the promise of employment to Nairobi. But employment is informal, irregular, and extremely low paid. People live from hand to mouth and are vulnerable to any unexpected difficulties. Residents working in the city mainly perform manual labor. The average wage is just 2 euros per day. Others set up a small business, like a hair salon, a market stall, an eatery, or a childcare. People sell clothes from the Dandora dump, or shoes that are hardly ever sold in pairs. Some women spend the entire day cooking chapati, which sells for around 4 cents each. If they can't afford charcoal, they will cook on plastic, which releases very toxic fumes. These boys lease a moped. They offer taxi rides and transport. The government owns all the land in Kibera. The average rent of a shack is 25 euros per month. Camel, goat, and cow bone is made into earrings, necklaces, and utensils. The remnants are sold as fertilizer to farmers outside of Kibera. One in five children born in Kibera doesn't make it to their fifth birthday. Most of these tragic deaths are due to diarrheal diseases. Other common diseases include malaria, tuberculosis, intestinal worms, typhoid, and cholera. The average life expectancy in Kibera is only 30 years of age. Let's have a look inside the homes. The walls are made of mud with sticks. It has a tin roof and a dirt floor. Children usually sleep on the floor. Due to the open sewage, large rats come into the homes. An average of 8 people live in it. There is often not enough food for the children. Many of them are underweight. They lack vitamins and proteins. While education is likely the best way to improve a child's future, here, most parents are not able to pay for it. In Kibera slums, there are over 60,000 orphans due to AIDS. They are cared for by grandparents or overcrowded orphanages. Sometimes they are completely left alone. It's estimated that at least 12% of Kibera's population is HIV positive. Desperate girls and women can be found trading their bodies for the price of a meal. Protest, dreams, and hopes are depicted on the walls. A women empowerment center helps rejected HIV positive women to survive.
Power. Women. Power.
Women.
Together, they are strong. The Origa Family Foundation raises funding for two projects in Kibera. We can help by supporting sack farming. The aim of the project is to raise money to initially provide 300 households with two bags filled with red loam per family, 60 varied seedlings, fertilizer, and shared hand tools. This way, families can have access to fresh vegetables for their own use. An amount of 1,100 euro is required for this. With more resources, this initiative can be extended to three villages in Kibera. This requires a budget of 3,300 euro. In this sea of garbage, in this land of dirt, any help is welcome. The second project involves raising money to build a sustainable toilet block with four toilets in Makina, Kibera. An amount of 1,700 euro is required for this. With more resources, this initiative can be extended to three villages in Kibera. This requires a budget of 5,100 euro. It's a privilege to be able to leave the slums, to go back to what we consider normal life. People in Kibera want to live. They have hopes and dreams like everybody else. Together, we can help to make their life a little bit better.